that found out that my soap light is out of alignment. It's no longer cut a straight line, a 90 degree line. So I'm attempting to address that. The first thing that we should always do is just to ensure that it's not plugged into any power source. So when I'm coming in this way, I exaggerated a little bit there, but the cut look like that. It is very hard. It is only a slight gap. So the gap is on this end. It is a little bit hard to see on a square, but it is there. It is there. Originally, I thought that my miter gauge is actually not in a 90 degree setting, but I try hard and it is 90 degree setting. I'm using a dial indicator to check out the squareness of the light. Let's just do that. The dial indicator that I got is a digital one, and the brand name that I bought is iGauging. So I just saw that logo. I just mark a spot on the light on this end toward the bike there, and I just set the dial indicator to touch it, and I reset it to zero. Now, so according to the instruction from other YouTuber. Okay, so what we have to do is just to pull this one back and rotate the soap light to the other end, and then pull this one back and set it into the same spot. Now, so the reading on this is around 0.21 mil, so quite insignificant, I'm guessing, but it is a problem regardless because it is a table saw, so we just want the cut to be as straight as possible. I locate a Russian video whereby the gentleman show how to adjust the carriage for the light. It is compared to some other show that I have seen on YouTube. It is quite tricky, but it can be done regardless. The bottom of the show is just a piece of metal screw onto the base by four screws, which can easily be unscrewed. Now, this is the important part, the part that I spend a bit of time to find out. So this is how I set the sole on this side. So this is the front of the sole where all the knobs are. Now, so coming down like that. So I set the sole on this bike, and these are the two screws. These are the two screws that we need to unscrew to adjust the carriage. So there's two there. And this is the head that I'm using. This is the head that we must use. This is also a Makita head. okay, so this one and this one, which I have unscrewed already. Now, so coming up here. Oh, hopefully we are able to see it from here. Yeah, they are, well, it's hard to let it in. So, but basically, they screw onto this and so that below there, underneath that. Oh, sorry, it's a bit hard to see. So, let me show you the two screws again. So let's just zoom in a little. There, they are there. That's one, that's two. And underneath it, there's another two, which we shouldn't touch. According to the video, the Russian video that I have seen, the gentleman He just somehow pushed the carriage over, using a piece of metal or something. I think I will have to do that off camera because I'm alone by myself and it's a bit hard to get that onto camera. Okay, so the problem that I have is, okay, so the saw is currently sitting like that and this is the blade there. So after I adjust it, I don't know how I'm going to get my dial indicator in there to measure it. I am attempting to measure the squareness of the blades as the saw is currently positioned and I am getting the same reading. So that means I can adjust the carriage and then re-measure the squareness again without having to lay the saw down. What I did was using this screwdriver there, I slipped it into that and gently move the carriage slightly over to the right. Now I can't say that I see it move, but I just now did a measure and they are actually zero on both end of the market point on the saw blade. So I think I'm going to tighten the two bolts now and then set the saw down and then do a re-measure again. The reading there is actually zero. Yep, okay. So it is actually zero there. It was zero before, so there's nothing on that point. Now, so I'm moving it back. Okay, now, so that also read zero. So that is what I am looking for. As I was saying before, I have already measured it before tighten the two bolts, so this is sort of expected anyway. I'm going to do a test cut of camera. I did a test cut and the results was a lot better than previously. So I think I'm leave it like this for the time being. I'm not really sure why it was out of square. I think I did hit some nail twice before. That may cause us to misalign, although the blade wasn't damaged so much because I stopped the saw in time and the nail, it was not very big. I do apologize for the quality of the video. I do understand that it is not of a very good quality, but I do hope you find something useful out of this as a beginner to the power tool. I'm just in the learning process at the moment. So for some of the advanced users, this may not be very useful, but for somebody who just starting out, I do hope that you find this useful. Thank you.